Hi, I'm Luke, and welcome to this general onboarding video for on-demand migrations. In the previous general onboarding video, we went over some basic things like settings and adding a tenant and granting basic migration consent. But in this video, we're going to go over some things that are more specific to on-demand migration, like granting additional admin consent for the tenant we added in the previous video. So to do that, we select our tenant and select the Go button. And you can see we need to grant consent for some additional migration capabilities, in which case we supply the global administrator credentials that we set aside for this and click accept. And we'll do the same with resource processing for SharePoint. We grant this additional consent so the account has permission to perform these specific actions so you don't get any errors. Next, in order to create a migration project, we're going to need at least two tenants added because you need a source and a target tenant. So we'll do that now by adding a second tenant. We'll supply the global administrator credentials and click accept. Now we need to click go on that tenant and grant the same admin consent rights that we granted the first tenant. Now that these are added and consent is granted, we can go ahead and create our first migration project by clicking the Migration tab and clicking Go. Here we select our source and target tenants, as well as the name of the project. It's important to note that if you had several tenants that need to go into a single target tenant, you would create a migration project for each of those with the same target tenant. But keep in mind, you'll have to add organizations to on-demand and switch between them in order to access their individual migration projects. Now that the first project is created, you get a notification of sorts in the top left that tells you to get started by creating or editing connections for this project. So you would select one of the tenants and click Edit, and this is where you supply the actual global administrator accounts that's going to be performing the migration operations for you. You can also change some options like concurrent PowerShell connections and a custom EWS URL. And if you supply a specific account that's going to be doing the migrating for you here, you can actually grant the necessary permissions here in the same screen. So we'll go ahead and do that now by clicking the Click Here button. And it's very similar to the grant admin consent process for the tenants that we went through earlier. We click accept and save, and we get a notification if the settings were saved successfully. And next, we'll do it for the target tenant. Now that the connections are configured, you can access them again by clicking Configure Connections. But your first task would be to create a discovery task, and you'll be well on your way to migrating with on-demand migrations. Also, if you're looking for any more how-to content for on-demand migrations, you can find a lot of how-to videos for migration under quest.com/TV and selecting On-Demand Migration underneath the All Products section. You can now consider yourself onboarded for on-demand migrations, but please make sure you view these other onboarding videos as well. Thank you for watching.